an inductive coil of resistance 3.1 ohm and inductor of 0.04 Henry is connected in parallel with a non-inductive resistor of 15 ohms across a 240 volts source 50 hertz supply. Determine current in each branch, power absorbed by the inductive coil, total current drawn from the supply and power factor of the circuit as a whole. And also draw the phasor diagram of the circuit. So the inductive coil, which consists of a resistance and inductance, that is resistance is 3.1 ohm and inductance is 0.04 Henry, that is R and L. This is no, he is telling as inductive coil. So I am representing as RC and L suffix C. And this is connected parallel to non-inductive resistor of 15 ohms. That is parallel means connected like this to a non-inductive resistor. So the resistor is non-inductive, that is only resistance is present of 15 ohms. Now this combination is connected across a supply like this, supply of 240 volts 50 hertz. And he is telling to find the currents in each branch, that is find current in the inductive coil and find current is in non-inductive coil. Suppose I represent it by I1 and I2. So let us find these currents. We know that as this is a parallel combination, the same voltage appears across this and the same voltage will appears across inductive coil also, that is 240 volts. So the same 240 volts across appears across 15 ohms and the combination of 3.1 and 0.04 Henry. Now first let us convert this inductive coil into equivalent impedance. It is Z suffix C, that is C represents coil. So Z will be R plus J XL. So the frequency is given, so we will convert XL to L. XL is omega L, that is 2 pi F into L. So 2 pi, frequency is 50 given and L is 0.04. This will be 12.56 ohms, which is XL. So ZC will be 3.1 ohm plus 12 plus J 12.56 ohms. This is the impedance of the coil. Or I can convert this rectangular form to polar form also. That is, you can see here polar is written. So shift polar 3.1 comma 12.56 bracket close, press equal to 12.93 and angle is 76.13 degrees. This is the magnitude of ZC. Or if I do, if I take out magnitude like this, that is under root of R square RC square plus XL whole square. If I do this, I will get 12.93 only. So we know the voltage is same across the both coil and non-inductive coil, that is 240 volts. So this I1 current will be, we know V is equal to I into Z. Now here we want to know, find the value of I1 and we have Z coil. So I1 will be V by ZC. That is voltage is 240 and nothing is, angle is given, so consider as 0 degrees and ZC is 12.93 at an angle of 76.13 degrees. So before angles there will be a normal division, that is 240 divided by 12.93, which will be 18.56. And the angles in division, the numerator angle minus denominator angle, that is 0 degrees minus 76.13 degrees. So the value of current 1, that is I1 flowing in the coil is 18.56 amperes at an angle of minus 76.13 degrees. Now similarly, let's find the current I2 flowing in non-inductive coil. we know that the voltage is same, that is 240 volt across 15 ohms also. So we know V is equal to I into Z. So here only R is there. So V is equal to IR, and we want to find I2 in this branch. So V is given as 240 volts, and we have to find I2. And what is R? 15 ohms. So I2 will be 240 divided by 15. It will be 16 amperes. Now angle will not be there here. Why? Because neither voltage has angle, and the impedance is only resistance. So no reactive terms are present. So that's why 16 amperes is our current I2, which is flowing here in this branch. Now the second is bit to find the power absorbed by the inductive coil. So this is the inductive coil, that is R and LC. The power absorbed by the inductive coil will be, this PC I am writing, denote is P coil, will be I square R, RC to be more specific, that because he is telling find the power in inductive coil. And the current is I1 here. So I1 square into RC. So we have I1, that is 18.56 amperes, this whole square, into what is RC? 3.1 ohms. This will be 1067.86 watts, or in kilowatts also we can write as 1.06 kilowatts, just divided by 1000. Now the third bit he is asking to us to find the total current drawn from the supply. Now we can convert these two impedances parallel into one equivalent impedance, so that our circuit becomes like one equivalent impedance and having one voltage source, so that we can find the supply current or the total current drawn by the supply. So the equivalent impedance will be, that is they are in parallel, so Z1 Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. That is, I mean, Z1 is our coil and Z2 is only resistance. So same as we do for parallel resistances, that is two resistances parallel, same we apply for impedance also. So let us calculate this like this. Now we can solve this in calculator. In calculator, please keep your complex mode on, that is select 2, and numerator is what? 3.1 plus J 12.56, so 3.1 plus 12.56 I you have to write instead of J, okay, into 15 divided by 3.1, same 3.1 plus 12.56 I plus 15 ohms. This will give me 6.6 plus J 5.82 ohms. This is my Z equivalent, or we can convert this into Z angle phi, that is, and the Z, as this is Z equivalent, the angle associated after conversion of this will be same as power factor angle. So let us convert this into polar form. First turn off your complex mode and press polar 6.6 comma 5.82, bracket close, it is 8.79 at an angle of 41.4 degrees, and this angle is your power factor angle, and the power factor is cos phi, that is cos of 41.4 degrees. This will give me 0.75 power factor lag. Why lag? Because first point is phi is positive angle, the current angle will be negative, and the main point of lagging is that inductive reactance is present. We know in In pure inductor, the current lags voltage by 90 degrees. So as inductor is present, the power factor lags. So power factor is 0.75. Now let's come back and to find our total current drawn from the supply. As I said you earlier, we have converted our circuit into somewhat like this with Z equivalent. Z equivalent we know. Let's find I. What is I? We know V is equal to I into Z. So I will be what? V by Z. So V is given as 240. If angle is not given, consider at 0 degrees. Z is what? We got 8.79 at an angle of 41.4 degrees. So before the angles, there will be a normal division, that is 240 divided by 8.79, which is 27.3 amperes at an angle of. Now I said you earlier that in division the angles numerator angle minus denominator angle, that is 0 minus 41.4 degrees, that will be minus 41.4 degrees. This is the supply current, okay, passing here like this in this circuit. Supply current goes like this and splits up into I1 and I2, then again becomes supply current. Now the fourth is telling us to find the power factor circuit as a whole. So we have already found the power factor angle, power factor as 0.75 lag. So you can also verify it. What is the power factor angle? Is the phase difference between voltage and current. So voltage angle minus current angle is power factor angle. So what is voltage angle? 0 degrees is there. What is current angle? We have already found our supply current and the angle associated with it is minus 41.4 degrees. So what will be power factor angle? 0 minus of minus 41.4, this will be plus 41.4 degrees. This is phi, that is power factor angle is 5 degrees, and if we substitute phi in cos phi, we will get 0.75 power factor lagging because the inductor is present. Now before drawing the phasor diagram, we need to know the values of VR and VL, that is voltage across resistor and voltage across inductor or inductive reactance. That is V, we know that the voltage across them is total voltage is V. So the vector sum is VR plus VL, or I can write VR square plus VL square under root. So we know V is equal to I into R. What will be VR? The voltage across resistor will be the supply current IS and resistance into times resistance. So supply current is 27.3, an angle of minus 41.4 degrees into what is the resistance? 6.6, and the angle associated with the resistance will be 0 degrees. So this will give me 180.18, that is before angles there will be normal multiplication and angles in multiplication will add. So minus 41.4 degrees plus 0 degrees will be minus 41.4 degrees. This is my VR or the voltage across the resistor, equivalent resistor. Similarly, let us find the VL. VL is voltage across the inductive reactance, that is J5.82 into supply current IS. So J5.82 means, J means the angle will be 90 degrees. So the supply current is 27.3 angle minus 41.4 degrees times 5.82 angle 90 degrees. Okay, this will be 158.88, and the angles will add what? Minus 41.4 plus 90 degrees will be 48.6 degrees. This is my VL. Now you can also verify this. That is, I already said you V is equal to VR square plus VL square under root. So if I do this, I will get approximately 240 volts, which is the voltage across them, the total voltage across them, or the supply voltage. Now let us draw the phasor diagram. So these are the values you need to know before drawing the phasor diagram of series RL circuit. Now you can take any one of them as a reference. I am taking the supply current as a reference. That is 27.3 amperes. Reference means you have to draw horizontally. At 0 degrees you have to draw. Okay. This is IS. And you can see the angle associated with it. Minus 41.4 degrees, which is the same as VR. So VR and IS will be on same platform or same line. Okay. So draw VR here only. Like this. So this is VR, that is voltage across resistor. Now we know that the current, supply current and the voltage across the inductor will have a 90 degrees phase displacement, or the voltage of the inductor leads supply current by 90 degrees. So it will be perpendicular to IS. So draw VL perpendicular to IS. Like this. This is our VL, the voltage across the inductor or inductive react, equivalent inductive reactance. Now we know that V is the vector sum of VR and VL. So how to add VR and VL? From parallelogram of vector addition, we can add them. So extend VL like this. VL will be same here also. And similarly, VR will be same here. So now connect VR and VL like this. This will be our supply voltage. This is VS like this. Now the angle associated with VS and IS will be what? 41.4 degrees. That is the power factor angle. This is power factor angle phi. This is the phasor diagram representation of RL circuit. You can verify from here also, that is VL, IS. I said you the phase displacement will be 90 degrees. Both of them. You can do minus 41.4, minus 48.6. You will get 90 degrees. It is. So that is the VL leads the IS by 90 degrees. Similarly, resistor and the current will be on same line. And you have also seen that how to add the two vectors. Okay, VL and VR, how they are added? By parallelogram of vector addition, they are added. So this was the phasor diagram and we have completed the answer. Okay, thank you.